Well, hi, hey, hello, everybody. This is Julie. I am here out of the mothballs from the scraps of my life. Oh, jeepers. It's been a long time since I've been on YouTube with a video. And the reason's really irrelevant. Been moving around, moved from where I was to the place where my husband's job had taken him to. Our house didn't sell, so after a couple years, I moved back to our house, to our home where we had built to retire in. And so we have it back up for sale again, and we're trying to sell it. Let's see if I can't move again. Yay! Anyway, I am so tickled. I have been off here by myself. My daughter left. She moved to Georgia, left me here by myself. And I had to find something to occupy myself besides rearranging the house, putting it back together, etc., etc. That got old fast, especially when I'm here most of the time by myself. So I said, you know, I can't do my craft room like I want to since I changed my craft room from before. I had it in a smaller room. When I moved away, I had this huge, nice size craft room, and I moved back. And I just couldn't get my stuff back into that small craft room again. So I took the larger upstairs room that we have, but it needs, cabinetry and storage. Well, I don't really want to invest the money in that until I know what's going on. So anyway, long story short, my stuff is still in boxes, and I couldn't, being a person who loves to be organized and go and, go know where everything is, can tell you where anything is in my house when I've organized it. Don't even have to go get it for you. Just tell you where it is, and there it is. I said, I have got to figure out a way to get back to my scrapbooking. So, as I said, everything wasn't unpacked. I was going through unpacking the books that I had started over the period of time I was away and didn't finish. A few of them, they needed covers on them and some finishing touches on the books themselves. And I said, you know, I'm gonna see if I can't pull the stuff out and finish those, because normally I keep that stuff together when I have an unfinished book. I normally keep, everything that I was working on it with in one spot, at least. Well, when I went to do that, I couldn't find some of it because it was packed in different boxes. And anyway, long story short, I was watching some YouTube videos and I was wanting to do a journal, the what do you call them? The leather ones, personal size leather Midori style journals. And I didn't have the leather, and I couldn't get a hold of any without, doing a bunch of homework, and I was stressed out over it. I said, forget it. So I tried to do one out of paper, and it was not the size I like, so I stopped working on that. And so I made this one here, and this one turned out pretty. This was my first one, and as a disclaimer, let me say that this is not my first book. This is my first Midori style journal. I am a longtime scrapbooker, been doing it most all my life. But this little project here, and this one here, first time I've ever done a journal, like you put the writing paper in, and normally I would just buy one and write in it, And anyway, these, instead of it being just a cover, I attached it, and this is a one signature journal here. And this was the first one I did. It turned out really pretty, but the fact that I did the little fancy stuff here on the corner made it so that I didn't feel comfortable with for myself using it on a daily basis. I wanted to use it on a daily basis. If you don't want to hear me yammer and jabber after being gone for so long, you're welcome to flip to someone else's video or fast forward. I don't know, whatever you'd like to do. I don't mean to keep anyone, but I haven't been on in a while, right? So I have a little bit to say, and I kind of need to, say a few things about this. You can see it's untied right now. But anyway, after a couple other fails that well, they weren't necessarily fails, they just weren't for me. And I wanted a journal. I wanted it yesterday, and I wanted to write in it. So I made this one, and I spent a couple of weeks working on it. And it turned out gorgeous. I mean, it's just beautiful. I love the details, and I love the I decoupaged the front of it and everything. And I did some what do you call the lace where it's dimensional. But after I had done that, I can't stand it. Even on this book, it's killing me. It looks so plain to me. This book looks so plain. But I keep telling myself, Julie, if you're going to use it on a daily basis and you're going to slip it in a bookcase occasionally, you do not want anything on this book. I keep telling myself that. I'm not convinced yet. But anyway, so anywho, back to this one. So I made it. I'll flip through it really quick for you guys because this was not supposed to be the center of attention. The other book is. So I'll just flip through the pages for you. So I think I may end up just giving this book to my daughter. She is planning a wedding, and this may be helpful to her. This is really not her forte. She's not a big flower person. And I asked her the other day on the phone if she would be interested in a journal to jot down the things that there's pockets in here so she can put receipts or whatnot. And I asked her, would she be interested in something like that? And she said, sure, I'm not picky. I'll take anything. Well, that's just because I made it. And I haven't really give her a book. I just never thought she was interested in my books. But she is, and I'm working on her a cookbook right now. But this is all coffee dyed, some stamping, lace, whatever. Whatever I stuck in here, it was just me. I just love this little piece of paper. I mean, it's just a piece of notebook paper stained, folded over, put underneath that. I just love stuff like that. Some of the paper is sparkly because when I coffee dyed it, I used a sprayer that had some of the Lindy's or whatever in it, and it sprayed the still had the glistening stuff. So I sprayed the coffee on some of them, and that being one of them. And it just turned out adorable. I mean, really, really pretty. I mean, there's no complaints on my side for that. I haven't done the center here yet. I've got to put some little bibber bobs on there. And the coffee, the coloring of the paper just turned out beautiful. I told my husband, I said, maybe it's because I used expensive coffee. I don't know. But anyway, it turned out really gorgeous. And but it, like I said, it has that layering on the front, and it's just not, what I want it or need it to be for me, because I want to use it. I want to use it. I have little books everywhere, and scraps of paper everywhere that I've written down things, and I try to save them and keep them together in one place. And eventually, they get lost, and stuff that you can never remember again. And I've been doing some electronic journaling, and it's okay, but sometimes when they update this is an envelope that I made. The program, the apps or whatever, you might lose your your stuff. And so I made that one. I'm going to see my daughter hopefully before too long in Georgia. My camera got it a little crooked there. And I'm going to take that to her and see what she thinks about it. This one though, oh my goodness, I am ecstatic. I sat here last night and squealed. I was so tickled about this book. I'm sorry about the computer here. It's doing a scan that I did not authorize. So, no, I don't want to download anything. I just sit here and squealed. When I got the signature sewn in, I just squealed. I said, I did it. What happened? Let me tell you what happened. I know some of you have done this. This is the second time I've done it. This is the second book that it happened to me on. I sewed the signature. I had all my, there's two signatures in this book, and they're pretty large signatures because I don't, like some of you, I don't know when to stop adding. But got the whole signature sewn together. Now I put this one in first, and I did great. I didn't mess anything up. I put it in, it was great. It was done. I set the book aside and I got the second signature and brought it over here to me and started, working my needle through it. Made my holes prior, of course, and started working my needle through and told myself, now don't forget that you have to run the needle through the book. Well, guess what I did? I sewed the whole entire signature and finished it just like this, tied it off and everything without the cover. So I had to go back, undo it, and sew it in the book cover. Anyway, what I did here was I took some of my, what do you call this new stuff? It's just great. It's fabulous. It's a little bit harder to manipulate and work with. And I did only put it on the spine area here instead of wrapping it like I would normally do. And the reason for that is I didn't want to cover up my roses. I had already put this on and decoupaged it, and I didn't want it covering up my roses. And I didn't feel like this little quarter inch here was enough to glue it to, because I had a whole cookbook that I did a video on to show you guys, and it fell apart. The tape came loose. So I don't know if it was a defectiveness in the tape or the book was just too heavy. I don't know. I mean, it was cardstock, so and it didn't even tear it, which is amazing, but it still came apart and now I don't know what to do with that. But I did know the name of this stuff, but I can't think of it right now. But I embossed it. It's that new non-tearable stuff that you can use and you can even wash. That's what that is. And I embossed it and I colored it and I did some Lindy's, a couple different sprays, and maybe even some bronze ink. I can't remember now. I did a whole lot of things to it and it turned out really pretty. It's got a pinkish color because I sprayed it with some pink, gold, and all kind of colors. Turned out pretty. And this actually started out, as you can see in the center of it, as a pink file folder. And you'll see that in a minute. Because in all the books that I've made, file folders seem to hold up the best above all else. So I wanted my cover to be nice and sturdy. And I wanted it to reflect the motion of leather, but yet have the durability of leather. So I took my file folder and used it, and I folded my file folder. This is the back of it. And I'm not finished with the back of this. I want to put a this I forgot to do this earlier when I decoupaged it today. I wanted to put this torn piece of doily here, like kind of like I did on the front there. And just because it just adds a little bit to it, and I can decoupage it and have some texture without having bulk. Hopefully I won't, get my fingers caught on it and tear it off. And that's a stamped rose, multicolor rose I did. I just love, you'll see this stamp a couple of different times because I absolutely love it. It is the most beautiful rose. I have it laying here somewhere. But anyway, and I did like two or three different things on the edge here. I did some metallics and just kind of layered them. I used one of them was this Tim Holtz. I've never really used this, the distress stain and the tarnished brass. That's the lighter color you see. And did a different cut, different metallic inks and whatnot. And that's just a piece of lace. You can hardly see it. Once I decoupaged it, you can't really see it very well, but there it is. So, okay. So, and then this is a piece of sticky mesh that I put here. I just thought it added a little bit of texture and interest to the cover without adding bulk. You know, I was trying really hard. So on the front cover here, what I did was on the spine, I did three layers of the file folder cut to fit. Okay, so I did, no, I'm sorry, two, the original layer and another layer, I think is what I did inside. And then I added this nice piece on the outside and it's completely stuck down. It is not going anywhere. And so that really gave me a nice stiff spine. But my pages are nice and bendable. I added, you know, the papers. This is a cardstock paper on top, and I folded the file folder over so that it would give me some firmness. But as you can see, it bends kind of like a nice leather. So I love how this book feels. And then I lined it with paper on the inside cover. And I added that little celebrate life. And I was going through my, I was looking, I was lo I'm always looking for something. Like I said, my you know, my things aren't all unpacked, and I was trying to find my words. I have a whole package folder thing of words and sayings that you just rub on or glue on, you know, sort of like this one here. And couldn't find them, but I found this package of things from another paper group right here. It's Glitz Whatnots, and it's the Cashmere Dame. And this bubblegum machine was in there. Now, before my daughter was born, my husband bought me, it's always been my dream, I guess. I don't know, childhood thing, I don't know, to have a bubblegum machine. So I've always had one. The old-fashioned looking red and black kind, on the metal stand and everything. And when I saw this, with all the things that I've had going on in my life, I said, you know, I need to remember, because this is a journal, and I need to remember to have fun, because I'm by nature, I'm not really a fun person, and I'm very serious, you know. So I put this in here. I was just going to slip it under the pocket, and I said, well, it needs to be a little bit more substantial, so I stuck it to this coffee dyed tag, and stuck it in here to remind me. So anyway, over here on this page, I have done a bird. Now I don't remember if this is Prima or not, but there it is. This is a pretty, my thing, roses and birds and flowers, that's my thing. So on the next page here, I just, this, of course, this paper, I added some more paper after I had coffee dyed my papers, and this was one that did not get coffee dyed. So I did some spray staining, and I did the double colors across my rows that I was telling you about that I really love, and this is, you can see it really well. It printed out pretty well here, and I did the what is that called? The Brilliance, and I did the chalk color box ink, the Chestnut Roan, and then I sprayed over top of that. So that's really pretty, and you can still write on this glitzy glimmer mist stuff. Over here, I did a doily. I should say before I go further in this book that I had purchased a book. I'm not going to show you the cover because if I do, you'll know whose book it was. But I purchased a book, and I don't want you to know because I don't want to reflect badly on anyone. But I purchased it and it was damaged in mailing. Okay, and I also purchased some extra smaller kit things. And so when you see these flip-ups like this, is because some of these pages were pre-made. These are not all pages that I, matter of fact, I don't know if any of my coffee dyed paper is in this book. The other one, yes, but this one, I don't know that any of mine is in here. But this was a pre-made book, and what I did was, since the cover got damaged, the pages did not get damaged. So I took the book apart, and that I commenced to make, put together another book. And what I did was, except for the spot that I'll show you, I just completely redid the book. I added my own stamping, and here in the corner where I did some ruffled paper, I added that. I added everything you see on this page, except for the fact that this was already. And of course, I can't tilt this one up, and I realized that when I made it. But I saw this little sticker when I was going through my things, and I liked it. And another reminder, to be kind. So, not that I need that, but we all need to be reminded of something once in a while. But these are just some tags, and you see them, you'll know where they come from. I love this one. You got this. Got a little bit of spray on there, so it just makes it look more vintage. Stamp up in the corner there that didn't quite take in the center. I stamped it after I put the book together. Not smart. This is the one thing that I couldn't completely change in this book without tearing it up. And I didn't want to tear it up. And it has a really nice pocket in the top. Really nice. I've got to get me some kind of tag to put in there. I guess I could just stick one of these nice coffee tags in there, so to remind me to decorate it and whatnot. There we go. And then this is just a flip down. There's some glue there somewhere. So I just recovered the bottom of it with to match my book with the paper I've used. And then through here, I left some pages plain because I do want to use this. I do want to write in it. I added this envelope here. Actually, this is a bag. I just did some stamping and made a tag to go in it because I just like the interest it added between the blank pages. And some paper here that I added that I did not coffee stain. So that's some more I added. So I did some treatment going on here with a couple doilies underneath the edge to make a little slip pocket here, and a tag I made. See, so here's the other side of that paper. I did not stain it or do anything to it. I just put a pretty stamp. That's how that stamp's supposed to look. And then the coffee's on this side. This little bookmark did come with the book, and I loved it. It's beautiful. And I just made a little paper tag to go over top of it, and with this paper clip, and added some ribbon. Just, fancied it up a tad. Same thing on this side. This is a tag that I purchased some coffee dyed tags from this young lady, and I just went and done some stamping and some glimmer misting and messying up of it of my own. That's the other side. And I just love how it turned out. I did a pink one. I think I've got it sitting here in front of me somewhere. There you can, if you could see my whole desk, you could see this is a working desk here. You've heard of a working woman, but this is a working desk. Let's see. Well, I thought that tag was right here beside me. My heat gun is. I actually found some of my things that I couldn't find. I looked everywhere for. Well, I'm sorry. I don't see the tag, so I'm gonna have to pass on showing you that. But it's pink, where this one's greenish blue. And these are the Lindy sprays. So gorgeous. This is another cute little thing I added here just for my purpose, just for me. To remind me, you are gorgeous somehow, in some way. And don't forget that, we're all valuable somewhere, some kind of way. These little small doilies, and all the paper bags were in the book. And I just left them in there because I loved them. These little guys like this, some of these I left. Not many, but I redid most of them. But this one, I liked it. I left it. I cut out this butterfly from the K and Company paper, and I made this gorgeous tag. I just love this. It was a hand and I couldn't use the whole thing, so I used the part that I could. And I just made a little booklet type thing for journaling in. Nice writing paper there. This piece here was also in the book, and it was made into, I added the stamping on it because it just begged for me to do something to it. And then I added this strip of paper at the top, and then I made a tag to go inside of it. It's just a bifold tag from some cardstock. Over here, more of that K and Company. Double-sided plain paper behind a butterfly that I cut out of the paper. Just stuck it up there just 'cause there's just a cut out from a paper line. I think this, I'm not going to go to say what I think because I'm not certain whose paper line that's from. This was in the book. Isn't that gorgeous? It looks like it was printed on with a printer. It's just beautiful. I added these borders that you see. The butterfly here, I took these little tags were on her signature, insides of her signatures, and when I took them apart, I didn't want to waste them. And I just thought that was a gorgeous place. It made the antennas for the butterfly and it put little heart strings at the bottom. It just so adorable. Let me see, can you see that? That's so cute. So that's where I put that one. I've got a couple more I've got to incorporate somewhere, and I put some lace behind that. And then I did a couple more border punching here. And in my signatures, I did the little leaves. I just thought it was befitting since there's so many flowers and butterflies, I did leaves instead of shapes from the paper. And I just love them. They're just so cute. That kind of got misplaced. That was not supposed to be just on a plain page, but I was moving stuff around and it got left behind. So there it is. So, okay. So here's some stamping that the young lady had done. So there's some of that in here on the pages. This is an envelope, journaling envelope that she created. So that's kind of cool. And I just changed out the paper that was on top because it was a color I didn't care for. So I just changed it to match the book. That's all. This is her little butterfly and collage over here to the right that flips up. Right here is just a tag that I made, and it's a bifold. And of course, in the center, it's white because I haven't done anything at all to it as of yet. I love these little corner pockets, they're just fantabulous. There is something, there's a butterfly in there. That's another butterfly, and he's so big. That's why I cut it out to journal on. I thought that'd be fun. I wanted to have fun. So that's why I made these journals. I wanted to get back into the knack of scrapbooking, and I thought, you know what better way? This is making these books like these were so less daunting because I just had to put a bunch of stuff together. I didn't have to sit there like I've done in the past and figure out which way to fold this paper, which way to fold this folder to make a pocket here or a section here. It was just fun. This was so much fun. It was like doing your favorite thing to do to relieve stress. That's what these were, stress relievers for me. So I really had fun, and I guess if the book hadn't got damaged, I wouldn't have had that much fun. So maybe that was worked out for the best anyway. So instead of getting it and just starting to journal in it, I just had a ball. I just had a blast, and I'm ready to do another one already. So this is just a journaling card and a journaling card that I made from paper from that can company. There's that gorgeous envelope. I made a band down the page here, put this beautiful flower, almost looks like a camellia rather than rose. And I have these envelopes, and they are really longer than this, but I couldn't comfortably fit it in this band. It just was just too barely too long. You can see it there. It has line. It's so cool because it has lines. I bought them for that reason. I was looking behind me to see if they're there. You wouldn't believe my room if you could see it. You just wouldn't believe it. But anyway, it's just long enough it wouldn't fit comfortably without pulling on my band. And I didn't want to use it that way, so I cut it down. And I made it shorter and I lined it with paper. And then I put this paper on the outside to match my band. And then this little card says make it happen. So that just worked out beautifully. And I just flipped a piece of lace over there. I didn't even glue it down. I like it the way it is. The colors are just amazing. I love this paper right here. So pretty. So vintage looking. And then I just flipped the paper over to the other side and the lace, and I did glue this down a little smidge so that it could be, used if I wanted to later glue that and use it for an up pocket. I can, or an up perch, whatever you want to call it. My computer keeps blacking out. Over here, I did a fold and I mean a pocket, a fold with the paper, which made a pocket, and then I done some coffee stain paper here. And punched it and just added some tags. So that's the paper that didn't get coffee stained there. That's the other side. Still pretty paper. It's got the best feel to it. Some more journaling pages, the other side of that bag. More paper. This is one of the edges that I redid, and I removed the butterfly from the tag and just added the butterfly back to the corner instead of instead of the little ticket. The other side of the other paper from the front. And that's the this paper's so pretty, isn't it? So there you can see the pink file folder because I didn't stain it in the center. And then here's some more beautiful paper. And I loved adding the now what happened here, this is paper from my stash, but I glued it on top of the paper that she had done because it was a color that didn't go with my book. So I just glued it right on top. If you can look, you could see that where I didn't get it exactly even. And then this is her compilation here. She did a flower, and I wanted to brighten up the color a smidge. So what I did was I sprayed the pink flower there you see in the background with some Lindy's, and then I added a colored flower on top, and then a button glued it on. So it really made it pop, and I love this stamp that she used. It's so pretty. It's like I wish I had something like that that I could do an all over stamp thing. Then I wouldn't have to do all so much spraying. But you know what? I love the sprays. I love how they turn out. So it doesn't hurt my feelings that I have to do it. This is a tag that she had in the book, and of course her little doily. But I stamped on laugh out of that brilliant stamp pad. So it's got gold and pink. It's so gorgeous. And then I done the brown little ring around it. I think that's the only tag. I wished I'd have put a couple more of those in here, but I didn't. This is more of my stash, and I just prettied it up a bit. This is another one. I'm trying to think. This is one of the papers that she used in the book, and it was all this color, and I just added this paper to it so I could have a flip out. So I added it here, and I was going to put some ribbon or something along here. That's why I kept it. That right there is the stamping. Isn't it beautiful? And then I sprayed over top of it and it's got the glistening. So pretty. So that's some more spraying I did. There is another little side of that bag, and this is a card that was in the book. It says postcard. So pretty. So soft and vintagey looking. And I just inked the edges of it. Added some lace to it. These two cards were in the book. This is like a bookmark, and I just added this punched border here to the edge to hold them because they just look so pretty in there with those colors. Okay, get back in there and quit being sassy. There we go. All right. Okay, so just more paper. I can't wait to write in this book. It's about to kill me. I was doing some finishing touches on it, adding a few things here and there, like the buttons over here on the front. I added these today. I just said I've got to have buttons somewhere. I'm trying to find 100 places to put them. So this is another one of the flip ups, and I just changed out the paper covers is really all to match the book better. Added this butterfly on top of the butterfly she had here, and I took him from the corner and used him here. So I recycled the things that I took off that she had done. I didn't throw them out or throw them in the trash. This paper, I took this paper over the edge just to add some color to match this page on this side. I just love how that looks. And I stuck a heart on her doily here because it's just makes these little birdies pop, doesn't it? Little bit of glistening, gotta have a little glistening. This is a tag I made out of some paper, and I made did I make this? Yes, I added this pocket. This was actually a page that you can buy in, to match the well, they used to have them where they match the kit paper kits and whatnot, and it's very, very lightweight paper. Oh, excuse me, good gracious, pardon me. And so it was so light that I had to add it to something. So I put it on this piece of paper that you see back here on the background so it would have some sturdiness to it, and left this side to journal on. A bag that I didn't, that's where that doily was supposed to be that got misplaced. Don't have anything in that one yet. Some layering of the papers. This is another, this is beautiful. These are some of my favorite springtime colors, summer colors. This was already in the book, and it looks like you know what I did? I put that in upside down, but I didn't even realize it till now. But that's okay. There it is. I make mistakes. Here's some coffee dyed paper. This is some coffee dyed paper that I did. It's really turned out pretty. I was working on a different book. That's put away for now. It's not finished. Got tired of messing with it. Another card. That pocket did have a card in it. This is a doily I punched out with the Martha Stewart round and round punch. I don't know what that's actually called, but I wanted to use that one because I wanted to be able to write on it. This is a band, and here's one of those envelopes that I left whole. So see, it already has all those lines. And you can just write right on them. And I kind of dolled it up a tiny bit, not much. And there's one of those flowers. Oh, goodness. See, I did this blue and pink. I don't know how well you can see it, but it matches this paper really, really nicely. And then it's got the gold glistening color over top. So I hated to put this in there because it covers it up. But that band ended up a little loose, and just anything will fit there. So that's why I put it there. Backside of that paper. I love the layering of this paper right here. It's so cool. I added the stamping to this. And there's some more of my leaves. So I'm going to go ahead and try to hurry up and do this. I did the punching on the border here, and it ended up a little long, which is why it's ruffling up. Did a fold over pocket here. Some more spraying. I love this paper here too. So pretty. So pretty. These tags here, I think these came with her book that I bought from her. I did the lace and the little flip over and the little flower here. It just turned out so cute. Just paper, because I gotta have somewheres to write, and there's nothing in that one yet. There's another lost doily. It might be the same doily. I don't know. I've lost track right now. I had made this to go in a different spot. I had watched Z let's see, Sagita. And I was watching her video that she was telling about how she made her beautiful flower stamp. It's so vintage looking. And sorry about that. So I got the idea to do a spray over. I had some lace. Actually, the truth is I was trying to color the lace. But there are some laces. It's right here. that don't color well, especially ones not made from cotton. This is more like a polyester. And so I had sprayed this with pink and it didn't look pink. So then I sprayed some darker stain, the vintage photo or something, I don't know, something over it. And it just looks like a dirty, I just hated the way it turned out. I was going to put it on one of my pages and I hated it. So I said, well, you know what? I'm just going to take it and use it for a mask. So I laid it down and sprayed the pretty inks over it. And it turned out looking really, really, really old. And I love how this turned out. It's just beautiful. You can see the pink and a little bit of the on the edges, and then the other colors that's all layered. But this is just coffee, coffee stain paper. Just made like a little flip thing to write on. And page I made back there. This is only where I recovered the paper. And I'm almost done. Another tag that came with the book. So she printed these tags. They're so pretty. They're so soft looking. And I just added the lace on the edges with a staple. And then there's the doily that goes with the bag. That's where it should be. And some more spraying I did. Paper, the other side of the tag, doily. This pocket I left just like it is for now, anyway. I may change it later, who knows? Well, like I said, I love that stamping. And then on the back here, I added some paper. I got that a little close to the edge, so I'm gonna have to kind of trim that off, it looks like. But I didn't glue this one down into a pocket. I wanted this one to remain movable and open, so I can open it if I need to. So I just cut this out from the paper from Marion Smith's paper line. And I believe it's Prima, and glued that onto the folder pocket there. So that's it. And I like I said, I had a ball. I had a blast. I'm sorry for all the interruptions, the sneezing and the phone ringing and blabbering on and on. But I had a ball and I can't wait. I'm going out of town for a little while. So I'm anxious to come back and start a new one. And so I may use some of the things already. I mean, like I've got five, six, seven paper lines pulled out here and pieces of paper everywhere. I haven't done a closure of any kind for this book because I don't know if it really truly needs it. It may just get in my way. So I might just, leave it like this. I mean, it turned out so good. And I do want to add a flip. A placeholder, a bookmark with something on it. I do want to add that. I just don't know where my things are right now. This is just from what I could find. So, anyway, everyone, thank you for watching. And hopefully, I'll be having some more videos for you soon and some more shares. And everybody, have a great and wonderful day, evening, whatever it is where you are. And thanks for watching.